Scholars, this is Mrs. Tyson, and today I have a guest on my show. Her name is?
Alea.
This is Alea. She's here to help us with lesson 20. Lele, can you please tell the sixth graders in my microphone, tell them what your favorite color is?
My favorite color is, I got a lot of colors, purple, white, and blue, that's it.
Oh, you got three favorite colors. That's awesome. Well, today we're going to do lesson 20. Can you say 20?
Say 20.
Good job. Today we're going to do lesson 20. And we're going to talk about putting Christ first. Lele, we're going to pray, okay? So would you start us off by praying? Go ahead.
Thank you for the night talk for my kids.
Sure.
Thank you for the podcast. Thank you for Chloe. Amen.
Okay, those are Lele's friends, so I'm just going to finish our prayer. Lord, I pray that you'll help us to love our friends and to take care of what they need during this time. We pray this in your name. Amen. Okay, thanks, Lele. We are in the book of Luke. Here's our verse. It goes like this. Ready, Lele? It goes, and I tell you, ask, and it'll be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Seek, and you will find. Knock.
Knock.
And it will be open to you, for everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds. And to the one who knocks, it will be open. What father among you, if a son asks for a fish, will instead of a fish give him a serpent? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask Him? Guys, if you have a better way to do that, go for it. I'm just trying to help you learn the verses. Make sure you know this for your quiz coming up. Our next slide, it appears that mine is stuck. Guys, what type of argument does Jesus use in verse 13? You just saw it. It's a fortiori. Lele, say fortiori.
Fortiori.
What gift does God give to those who ask for it? He gives the Holy Spirit. Say Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Good job, Lele. Okay, here we go. Circumstances can influence people and events, producing, say change.
Change.
Good.
Diaper change.
Today, we're going to write the theme statement and a summary statement. Here is our graphic organizer. It's called a main idea framework, or just idea framework. So you need to take a look at this idea framework. At the top, you're going to give a one-word idea of the text. I'll give you an example of that today. Then below that, you're going to create a theme statement, which is a sentence that's a universal statement. Bye. It's a sentence that's a universal statement based on that one-word idea. All of these ideas come from the text. So you read the text and you think, what's a one-word concept that I could pull from this text, that this text is mostly about? Then you take that one word and you create a statement that's universal, which is applies to everybody in the universe. That's how I remember it. And it's not specific. Like, it doesn't use the word Jesus or the disciples. It's like people tend to, and it's like a general phrase, okay? Then you're going to pick one of these and put it here and make it your theme idea framework. And then you're going to put supporting details below it from the text. You use verses from the text. You put it in your own words. And then at the bottom, you do your summary statement. If you want a bonus, you can send me an email with this theme restated as your personal perspective. Okay, we're not working on that right now in our exit ticket. But here are the verses for today. It goes like this. Get ready, Lele. Now there was a man named Joseph. Say Joseph.
Joseph.
Joseph from the Jewish town of Arimathea. He was a member of the council, a good and righteous man, who had not consented to their decision and action, and he was looking for the kingdom of God. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then he took it down and wrapped it in a linen shroud and laid it in a tomb cut in stone. Yep. Go ahead. Yep. Where no one had yet ever been laid. It was the day of preparation and the Sabbath was beginning. The women who had come with him from Galilee followed and saw the tomb and how his body was laid. Then they returned and prepared spices and ointments. On the Sabbath they rested according to the commandment. But on the first day of the week, at early dawn, they went to the tomb, taking the spices they had prepared. And they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they went in, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were perplexed about this, behold, two men stood by them in dazzling apparel. And as they were frightened and bowed their faces to the ground, the men said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee that the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified and on the third day rise?" And they remembered his words. And returning from the tomb, they told all these things to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene and Joanna and Mary the mother of James and the other woman with them who told these things to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. Oh, that's crazy. So as the women went and saw the angel and ran back and told the others, and nobody believed them. They thought it was an idle tale, verse 11 says. But Peter rose and ran to the tomb, stooping and looking in. He saw the linen cloths by themselves, and he went home marveling at what had happened. All right, scholars, what we're going to be doing is I'm going to show you this Lumo video at the very end. But first, I'm going to show you this exit ticket. So I just want you to know you're going to do your verse just like normal. And then right here, you're going to write in the lesson objective, which was on the slide in the video. Hold on. Then here's the text I just read for you. Then it says, what is the name of this visual tool? There's some options. Then it says, what are three concepts from today's text? So I want you to use the text, which are possible concepts, okay? Take a look at the verses, those should help you too. Then you're going to write, which is a universal statement for this concept? Which one's a universal? Remember, universal has to be applies to everybody. It says right here, it's not specific. It can be applied to anyone in the universe. Then this one says, what's a universal statement with a concept shocked? What's a universal statement with a concept? Oops, that should say doubt. Sorry, I'll change it. And then you're going to use one of these statements below. So it says, choose one of the theme ideas above. Write a theme statement. So you're either going to choose surprise, shocked, or doubt, and you're going to write a theme statement for whichever one you think this passage is most about, okay? Then it says, what is a supporting detail to the theme you chose? Then you write a second supporting detail and a third. Guys, if you need help on these, go ahead and look at yesterday's lesson video again and see if you can find it. What could help you with it. So what I mean is the supporting detail is using your own words, what's a fact from the story, like an event that happened that supports your theme. So you might have picked shocked as your theme. What's an event that shows there was shock going on? You might have picked surprised. What's an event that showed surprise was going on, okay? And then you're going to write at the very end, you're going to write a summary of the text, okay? That should be in the form of somebody wanted but so then. Scholars, I'm going to go ahead and play this Lumo video, and when you're done, go ahead and start your exit ticket. I also just want to apologize for the difficulty. I think something happened with our Chromebooks, and things were blocked today. So thanks for being patient on that. Here's the video.
Now there was a man named Joseph, member of the council, a good and upright man, who had not consented to their decision and action. He came from the Judean town of Arimathea, and he himself was waiting for the kingdom of God. Going to Pilate, he asked for Jesus' body. Then he took it down, wrapped it in linen cloth, and placed it in a tomb cut in the rock, one in which no one had yet been laid. It was preparation day, and the Sabbath was about to begin. The women who had come with Jesus from Galilee followed Joseph and saw the tomb and how his body was laid in it. Then they went home and prepared spices and perfumes. But they rested on the Sabbath in obedience to the commandment. On the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground, but the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee? The Son of Man must be delivered over to the hands of sinners, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again." Then they remembered his words. When they came back from the tomb, they told all these things to the 11 and to all the others. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the others with them who told this to the apostles. But they did not believe the women, because their words seemed to them like nonsense. Peter, however, got up and ran to the tomb. Bending over, he saw the strips of linen lying by themselves. And he went away wondering to himself what had happened.
Awesome, guys. Let me know if you have questions. Thank you. Bye. Hey, it's best to text me too. I'm teaching my kids during the day and my own kids. And so text me if you have questions, okay? Bye.